In this one, I will show you the Levenshtein distance algorithm, which is used to get the edit distance between two strings, which is very useful when you're trying to do some spell checking, mainly. So I have here an old program that I made, which uses the Levenshtein distance. And so, for example, if I type a word here, let's say house, you can see that it will sort them in an order that makes sense if you want the least amount of edits between this string and the other string. So let's say I make a typo and I say house, you will see that house is still at the top because it's the most probable one. But then if I make another typo, oh, house is still at the top because it understands that it only took me two edits to get, it's two edits far from house. And so that's how you can make a list of possible words to correct spelling mistakes. And so yeah, I will just quickly explain you how to build that algorithm in C, of course. So here you can see that I have some function that takes that does the minimum of three numbers. It really doesn't matter, it's very simple. And I'm gonna now write a function called lev, which will be your Levenshtein distance function, which is gonna take two strings, S1 and S2, and it's gonna return an integer, which is gonna be the edit distance or the Levenshtein distance between those two strings. So it starts very simple and quite intuitively. So if S1 is empty, so if the first character is the null character, then you can return the length of the second string, like so, which of course makes sense because if you have an empty string on one side, well, the amount of edit you need to do, the number of characters you need to add is the length of the second string. But and then you can replicate that for the second string. So if the second string is empty, well, the edit distance is the length of the first one. And then if now you know that there is at least one character in the two strings, so what you can do is if the first character of the first string is equal to the second character of the second to the first character of the second string, so if they both start with the same character, then you can return lev of s plus 1 and s 2 plus 1. So basically what happens if the two first characters are the same, you can just advance one character and do the Levenshtein distance on the tails of the string or the rest of the strings. Because you know that you don't need to edit the first character, so the edit distance will be maybe later in the string. And if that still and then if the two first characters are different, you can return one plus the minimum of something, and you add one here because you know that there is a difference in the first character, so you know that you're not gonna need to do at least one edit, and then you recursively call the lev on s1 and then s2 plus 1, so the first string unchanged but the second string advanced by one. Then you do the same thing with s1 plus 1 and s2 plus remaining the same. So you're trying to check all the possible combinations, you know, like you want to check if I don't move this, if I don't remove a character in this one, what's the edit distance? If I don't remove a character in the other one, what is the distance? And so on and so on. And you also want to check if you remove both the first character in both strings. So it would be like you fully substitute a character. Plus one, like so. And since you take the minimum of those three combinations, it will compute the edit distance for those three cases, and whatever the shortest path or the least amount of edit you can do to reach the other string, it will take that one, which also makes sense. And so, yeah, that's about it. You can see here in my example, I have just a Wikipedia example. We're gonna compare kitten and sitting. So you can see that we're gonna first need to change this K into an S. That's one edit. Then all of this is the same. Then this E is gonna change into a I. That's one more edit. And we're gonna need to insert a G. So that's three edits in total. And well, I already spoiled it because I forgot to clear my terminal, but indeed the distance is of three characters. And of course I can prove that if we have this, the distance will be two. And if we have this, the distance will be one. And if I fix the last character, the distance will be zero. So yeah, I hope it all makes sense. So yeah, that's the basics of it. But of course this is, well, maybe not of course, but this is like the clean or like the human appealing implementation where you have clean recursions and it's quite easy to understand. But of course this is horribly unoptimized. It's like when you, if you've ever done Fibonacci, the Fibonacci sequence recursion, you know that it will, if you do it the naive way, it will recompute the same value a lot of times. So you're gonna have a lot of times the same recursive calls, which is quite wasteful. And that's why you need some sort of caching, so that whenever you call with some parameters, your recursive function, it will remember those parameters and it will remember the return value associated with it. And so it, next time you try to call with the same parameter, it will directly return the value without actually doing the whole computation. And so that's kind of what you can do in with the Levenshtein distance like this, although there is an even better way, which is by creating a matrix like so. And basically this matrix will compute all the Levenshtein distance for all the character combinations. And there is a much more efficient algorithm, but it's less, I don't know, it's less eye candy, let's say. But so yeah, the matrix basically acts as your cache of values, and this is very fast compared to the implementation I just showed. And yeah, if you're curious, here is the like the more math implementation, well, not implementation, definition of it. So you can see that lev AB, if B is equal to zero, you return the distance of A. If A is equal to zero, if the length of A is equal to zero, you return the distance of B. Then if they're both the same, you return the Levenshtein distance of the tail of both of them. And here it's one plus min of all the combination of the tail. So yeah, that's basically the math version of whatever I wrote in the code. And yeah, that's about it for the Levenshtein distance. I hope you learned something useful. And yeah, learn how you can make a cool spell checker. And yeah, see you.